time on my ride. Well, Travis called me a few weeks ago, and he said, hey, dude, I got this big ramp set up into this airbag, and nobody really wants to hit it. The freestyle guys are kind of not really sure about it, and the moto guys, some of them are hitting it, but we need more. So he called me up, and he was like, you want to come to Maryland and hit this thing? And I was thinking, man, I've wanted to come out here forever, and I saw a video of the ramp, and it looks scary, super scary. And I knew Dayton didn't have a camera yet, and there were some things that needed to be worked out. But, you know, honestly, I was thinking, I need to come anyways. I don't think there's any way I could pass this up. So I was planning on coming, and then it worked out that Dayton got a camera, and we made it happen. So we've been driving for freaking, like, what was it, like 23, 25 hours, something like that. We drove for that long. We got here, talked to Travis for probably like 30 seconds before he's like, get your gear on, you gotta learn how to flip. It's getting dark. But he came over there, he's like, I gotta go to a family dinner, and if I really thought there was a chance you were gonna crash really bad, I would stay and watch. So, he goes, so, we're good. Go ahead, just go, you're gonna backflip into this foam pit, and then you're gonna front flip that 75 foot ramp out there. So what's wrong with you?
Brett's gonna do his first backflip, and it's gonna be awesome in Travis's foam pit.
Dude, I don't want to come off that thing again because that's too much work getting out of that. Did a backflip or a few of them into the foam pit, and then we went back. It was about to get dark, so we went back to the airbag, and I was pretty scared, honestly. Like,
you're softening all the air vents out of that, so you'll hit the top layer, then you should never really go through the bottom layer. Like, that should always catch you.
And then adding a front flip in there, that was like, I've never really flipped a dirt bike ever. And just the kicker thing on the top and the whole thing just doesn't make any sense. Like, it's ridiculous that you should have a kicker on the top of the jump like that to send you into a front flip. There's no reason that should be okay. And he's just like, tuck, just tuck, and you're good. You're gonna be fine. So it was a lot easier than I thought, but it was pretty terrifying the first time, I'm not gonna lie to you. I was pretty scared. So whenever we went back to hit the big bag, that was the same area that Josh did his triple flip in, it was a different ramp. It's a ramp that was maybe, I think they said it was like 10 feet shorter, but it was still huge. It was the biggest thing I've ever hit. But it was straight up and down. You had to go third gear pretty much wide open to make it to where you want to on the bag. And also you have to go a little bit to the side. Like, you had to aim off to the right a little bit. So that was where I screwed up the first time. I thought I aimed far enough right, and I didn't. I made the bag, bike didn't.
I have no idea what's gonna happen, but it's gonna be awesome.
No left turn. I know in the Pastrana Land we've always said no right turn. He did the same thing Jacko did. Don't turn left. The airbag is 40 foot wide. However, when you're hitting a third gear pin, you're going 80 feet in the air. That's only 15 feet on each side before something like that happens.
And then as soon as I went off the ramp, I knew I was in trouble. So I was like, I better let this son of a gun go, because I'm going off the side of that thing if not. Yeah, I know. Sorry, Chris. That was Chris's spare bike, but I'm kind of glad it wasn't mine. I probably I'm kind of scared to ride mine now after seeing that, but it's gonna be all right. We're gonna come back strong. Time at this game. You can't say the M-I-N-E word. I don't quite understand it. I wasn't really filled in on it before, and all of a sudden I say it and they're like, down 20 push-ups. But it's like an unreal feeling whenever you're up in the air for so long. I've never jumped anything like that. I've hit some big jumps before, and it gave me a whole nother respect for Josh doing that triple on it. I mean, that ramp was bigger. The landing was big. Everything about that thing is just ridiculous. I can't thank Travis enough, honestly, for making me step out of my comfort zone a little bit. And it's good to scare yourself once in a while, I think. And he reminded me of that. So can't say enough about that.
He wants us to do front flip knack-knacks. Now, front flip's a little tricky on its own, but you know, Travis Pastrana has to throw a knack-knack in there because he's Travis Pastrana. So
he really knows how to calculate things and calculate the risks that he takes. Yesterday, whenever him and Duffy were trying to learn how to do front flip knack-knacks, they were gonna do side-by-side ones, which was gnarly, and they did it. They both rode it out, it was sick. But we spent half the day just on that airbag, marking spots where they landed and how they were coming in and just making sure everything was perfect before they went and did it. And that's something that people don't get to see, and it was cool to see how he does that. And it gave me a whole new appreciation for it, honestly, because even I've known Travis for a long time, and I've seen a lot of the stuff behind the scenes, but I really didn't realize how much work went into landing a trick before they even do it. Kind of like whenever Josh did his triple, even the same thing. Like that was months and months of getting ready for it. So.
A lot worse, that's for damn sure.
Yeah. I've had fun. It's been awesome. They've treated us like family here, and I was nervous coming here, honestly. Like it's been something that I've had a chance to do, and I've never followed through with it, but I'm really glad I did, and I'm really looking forward to coming back. I know they're not here a ton, but next time I have a chance, I'm not missing it, so it's been good. Now, let's drive home.